Hello everyone, welcome back to the Hindu Explainer series. I am Kushagra Goyal and a very warm greetings from Law Prep Tutorial. Yesterday we highlighted to you why you should subscribe to our Telegram channel, right? And how it helps you in confirming that you are being consistent with what is being taught or explained about the newspaper, that you are retaining that knowledge, right? So I hope and I request all the viewers of our YouTube series to once again reiterate that you should press the bell icon and subscribe to our Telegram channel for updates about the daily quiz and the word of the day. On that note, I will begin with today's newspaper. Before we do that, we'll be doing the doubts, right? So yesterday we talked about how Novak Djokovic has become the player at the helm of ATP rankings for the longest time period, right? So ATP rankings include, apart from the four Grand Slams, other tennis tournaments that keep on taking place, right? But the most important thing about tennis are the four Grand Slams. They are the four oldest tennis opens that take place, beginning with Australian Open in mid-January, then the French Open in summer times, then Wimbledon that happens in around the month of July, and lastly the US Open, all right, which happens around September, October. So four Grand Slams are the one that count the most in terms of overall award. However, ATP rankings are determined along with the four Grand Slams on other titles and opens that take place, all right? So for example, India hosts the Chennai Open, right, which is a ATP backed tennis tournament in India, but Novak Djokovic may not have participated in it. So that is how rankings are determined for ATP. However, for record purposes, the four Grand Slams become the most important thing, right? Australian Open and US Open on the hard court, French Open on the clay court, and Wimbledon happens on grass court, all right? Then moving on, another doubt was regarding OPEC and OPEC Plus, right? So OPEC is one grouping. OPEC Plus includes members of OPEC plus 13 other members, all right? This is something I had discussed a couple of days ago, and we will provide you with the link to that in the description box, where I have enlisted all the members of OPEC, all right? If there are further doubts about it and there is any major update from there, we will be discussing that, right? Then there was one interesting question regarding reservations and part of basic structure, all right? So see, there has been no specific judgment that states whether they are part or not. They have been part of the Constitutional Convention since the beginning of the Constitution. Till now, no government has reduced reservation. They have always increased, all right? So one thing about basic structure is that if a particular thing is in basic structure, you can increase the scope of it but cannot reduce. That is what the doctrine in the Keshavanand Bharati case was about, all right? And as Supreme Court has not answered this question, I cannot comment on it, right? Then moving on, another doubt that students had was regarding the Covaxin's overall efficacy. So when we read the report, that was a study published by the Bharat Biotech company only, where they enlisted their total efficacy, which was claimed to be higher than Covishield, that is by the Serum Institute and AstraZeneca. The news that we read yesterday was about the efficacy of Covaxin vis-a-vis published in Lancet. Lancet is an independent science journal, therefore it is different. It is verified reports, all right? So phase 3 study data has not been published in Lancet yet, all right? Once that is done, all the details about the trials, how many volunteers got infected, how that happened, all of that will be known to us, all right? On that note, we will begin with today's newspaper. So one major update yesterday from the Kerala High Court. The Kerala High Court issued notice to the central government and restrained the central government from taking actions under the new IT rules against a news portal that is Live Law, all right? that not complying with part 3 of the new IT intermediary guidelines and digital media ethics code rules 2021, that it was claimed that this news portal was not in compliance with the new rules and hence complaint was filed. However, right now the proceedings have been stayed. All right. So that is one major update regarding the IT rules. We will be keep hearing these news about the IT rules. What becomes more important as of right now is to understand that one, the constitutionality of this has been challenged in different high courts and the petition is now pending, waiting for reply from the government. Secondly, as of right now, the structure of the rules becomes most important for us to be in aware of. All right. Then moving on, yesterday, Garhwal MP Trinath Singh Rawat took oath as the new chief minister of Uttarakhand state. All right. One important thing, that first he was elected the leader of the BJP legislature party. All right. So why was this done? Because a chief minister needs to be the majority leader, needs to be the leader of the MLAs of the house. All right. So as of right now, he is not the member of the legislative assembly. Within 6 months, he needs to get elected to be continuing in office of the chief minister of Uttarakhand. All right. So more updates, we'll have to wait. What new thing, that Trinath Singh Rawat has been appointed the new chief minister of Uttarakhand. All right. There was one question that the BJP government lost majority in the comment section. I will comment that no, that did not happen. The person that was Trivendra Singh Rawat, he lost majority support of his MLAs. His MLAs did not want him to be his lead, their leader anymore. The party did not lose majority in the house. Therefore, they are the ones who will have appointed the new chief minister also. All right. Then moving on, more political. Haryana government defeats no trust vote. All right, a no confidence motion was moved in by the Congress party in the Haryana Legislative Assembly, which was defeated. All right, then moving on the national page, nothing of importance for us. More updates from different governments about their budgets and policies. All right, moving on to the editorial front. All right, so on the left hand side, the main editorial, tectonic turbulence in Dravidian politics. This is analyzing the state of politics in Tamil Nadu. We know assembly elections are due in Tamil Nadu and the two tallest leaders of Tamil Nadu, that is M. Karunanidhi and Jay Lalitha, have passed away in recent times. So they were the two stalwart leaders of their respective parties, that is AIDMK and DMK. All right. And they were the focal points. Now that they are not there, there are claimants to their roles or the vacuum left by them, is what this editorial is discussing. Because it is political editorial, it is not relevant from CLAT perspective. All right. You are not supposed to know who will be the leader, who is what kind of politics, all of that. All right. Being aware of it is good. However, now that exam is getting closer and closer, you should focus on only what is relevant. Right. Then on the left hand side, uphill rescue, the top change in Uttarakhand is indicative of the limits of running a state from New Delhi. This is analyzing that in the current assembly of Uttarakhand, the outgoing chief minister was not popular by his own MLAs, but was an appointee or a person who was chosen by the parliamentary committee of the Bharatiya Janata Party. And the editorial lists out how this is a limitation, that when you become too unpopular, the party needs to react to that. All right. Which shows that, see, how is this relevant for us from constitutional scheme of things? Because in India, we have a parliamentary system of governance, right? the executive is first responsible to the legislature. And as the executive was taking decisions that were unpopular within the legislature, the person or the executive had to change. All right. This shows the power of collective leadership, that the MLAs believe that this person is not the best person to lead the state and therefore had to go. Now, a new person has come in which the MLAs have reposed faith in. This is the mechanism of parliamentary system of governance. All right. Then on the left hand side, regulation redux. An environmental regulator can work only if the government sees the value of nature. That this is enlisting. Yesterday we talked about how environmental regulator to undertake environmental impact assessment has not been there, and the Supreme Court has asked the central government to reply why that has not taken place. The editorial then lists out that, see, all of this will only happen when the government cares for the nature, because environmental impact assessment is basically to understand what is the impact of a particular action on the overall environment. All right. Under what act does all of this feature is the Environmental Protection Act of 1986. All right. So that is the only thing we need to know. Then the second, the other editorial, a case for revamped need-based public distribution system. In India, under the Food Security Act of 2013 and prior to that also, people have a social security to subsidized food grains. All right. And this editorial lists out that how there is now a need to change this mechanism, all right, because of the overall leakages in the system. What are leakages? Leakages is basically holes. So you intend to, for example, a water tank, you intend to hold it water for one purpose. However, because of leakage, the tank's water is receding outside and is getting evaporated. So the point for which you were storing water is getting defeated because of a leakage. The editorial here lists out how, because of the leakages in the current public distribution system, the beneficiaries are not being really benefited. All right. So that is the one concern here. However, because this is a policy editorial, it is not relevant from your perspective. All right. Then moving on, Nepal at a crossroads. All right. This editorial is listing out what the state of things are in Nepal. All right. The political situation in Nepal is precarious. Prior to the last elections that took place in Nepal, the Communist Party, or the Nepali Communist Party, Nepal's NCP, merged, in the sense that different factions of the party had merged, or communist had merged. Who were those? They were CPM, UML, that was led by KP Sharma Oli, who was the incumbent prime minister there, and CPN's Maoist Center. So the Maoist and the Communist Party had merged. All right. Now that they are meant for a split, because KP Sharma Oli did certain actions that were not supported by his party, so it is bound to split. All right. Now this is analyzing who can support whom and how government can formulate, because to run a government in a parliamentary system, you need to have majority in the house. After the split, there are two concerns that this editorial is highlighting. First one, that once the split is formalized, that is the election commission and it is confirmed, who will have how many numbers in the house, all right? That is still a question mark. The second is, once the numbers are out, the other party in the picture is Nepali Congress, NC there, all right? So who will the NC side with? Will they side with the Oli faction, or will they side with the Prachanda faction, is what the question is. This is what this entire editorial is talking about, that there are two factions of the Nepali Communist Party that are now meant for a split. All right. There is no confirmation of how many members will be splitting, who will have how many seats, and whether the election commission will confirm it or not, because it has not done so yet. All right. Under pressure from KP Sharma Oli is what is being claimed. The next thing is that the other party in the house, which is Nepali Congress, who will they go with? Because only they can ensure a party after the split has a majority in the house. So they are basically the king makers in the picture. Now we need to wait about what happens there. All right. So this is what the editorial is talking about. Then towards peace on the border, this is Ram Madhav, a member from the Bharatiya Janata Party, writing the posturing of overall peace at the border, that we have had withdrawal from China at the Pangong So Lake on the north and south banks. In other areas, the withdrawal has not yet been confirmed. However, one, withdrawal is good news, and second, that overall ceasefire agreement, DGMSO have confirmed that 2003 ceasefire agreement with Pakistan will be upheld, is what he's talking about. All right, so this is about we reaching a more enduring peace at our borders. Then diagnosing gestational diabetes. This is talking about explaining what is gestational diabetes and how March 10 is supported by different diabetes and health organizations across India as National Gestational Diabetes Awareness Day on March 10. All right. So this is explaining the disease of how it happens and the preventions to it and the date. All right. So the date and the disease is something that you need to be aware of. All right. Then moving on, the data point talks about the overall rise in COVID cases. All right. Then moving on the other national news, more and more political updates. Then here, TV channels warned against violating code. What is this code in question? This is the program code that TV channels need to be abided by, which is Cable Television Networks Regulation Act of 1995. And how, if you violate it, different actions can take place. So this is regarding actions against TV channels in Karnataka. All right. So these are mere directions that comply or else punishment will be imposed. When that is happens or not, that is when we'll discuss it in more depth. Then moving on the parliament side of what is happening in the parliament, two bills were cleared yesterday by the houses. First was Delhi's Unauthorized Colonies Regularization Act, and the second by the Rajya Sabha was amendment to the Arbitration Act. All right, nothing, two things not of real note. Then the Supreme Court has issued notice to central government about not a single woman being part of the National Defense Academy. All right, and how this is part of a systematic discrimination that takes place at the organization. So whether that takes place or not, now more updates need to come out. All right. Then moving on the other national news, more states of India have come out in support of undertaking or uptaking Myanmar refugees, people who are escaping Myanmar because of the military crackdown there. Confirmation from the Ministry of Home Affairs is required for all of this to happen. All right. Then US Defense Secretary will be visiting India from March 19 to 21. Lloyd Austin, the US Defense Secretary, will be visiting. Now, what will be the agenda? All of that is what needs to be discussed. All right. Then India not part of Russia's meet on Afghanistan. This news is distinct from another news that we will be talking about. So US agreement on or Doha agreement with US and Taliban is something that we discussed yesterday. The US Secretary of State Anthony Blinken has come out with one proposal. All right, that is distinct. We will be doing an in-depth analysis of that today. This news is separate from that, completely separate. All right. What is this telling us? This is about Russia. Russia trying to engage into a conversation about peace in Afghanistan. All right. So who are the members who have been invited? There is a term known as trioikia. The trioikia includes US, China, and so the original trioikia is Russia, US and China. And in this article, you will see trioikia plus. That plus is Pakistan. All right. So this is Russia trying to get a sense of things about what is happening in Afghanistan. And this conversation will also have representatives from Kabul, that is the democratically elected government of Afghanistan, along with member from Taliban. All right, this is separate from US led talks for peace. All right, this is US participating with Russia to appraise them of the situation in Afghanistan. What is the plan of action? How do these countries respond to what is happening there? All right, so we have to wait of what happens. The Ministry of External Affairs has not commented how they see India not being invited, because Pakistan has been, China has been, and this is by Russia, who is also considered an ally of India, but India has not been. All right, then moving on. On the international news, there is article on the left about Biden's peace plan. This is the US proposal for peace in Afghanistan. So the first article is by Russia. This is US plan. This is what we will be discussing in depth. All right. Then Joe Biden yesterday confirmed that how he sees Indo-Pacific as an important region, and therefore Quad summit will take place on March 12. All right. So summit level, that is the heads of the state will be participating on Quad, that is the grouping of US, Japan, Australia and India. All right, four countries, and Joe Biden has placed them at the center of overall foreign policy from his administration. All right, and China has commented on this, that this is conducive for peace. All right, that this is good news. All right, then moving on, UNSC, the United Nations Security Council, has slammed violence in Myanmar. However, it has stopped from using or condemning army's takeover. All right, so what have they criticized? The Security Council's resolutions are binding on its members. So what have they criticized? They have criticized the violence on protesters, but not criticized the army takeover of a democratic action because of resentment from India, China, Russia and Vietnam. All right, then moving on, India filing appeal against Cain Energy arbitration award. So we know that Cain Energy is moving in for imposition of the arbitration award, that is $1.4 billion. Indian government is now planning to appeal it. Once we appeal it and the appeal is accepted, the proceedings will stay. All right, so that is the plan. Apart from that, on the sporting and economic front, nothing of real note. Moving on to the Afghanistan situation. So two things we need to understand before we discuss what is the scenario. All right, so this is United States. All right, so the status quo is US wants to leave Afghanistan by May 1. All right, they know that the situation in Afghanistan, the ground reality, has not changed. Taliban is not on wane, but is on ascendancy. All right, so now US wants other countries to be collectively responsible to ensure peace in Afghanistan. So who are being called in for this process? All right, so this is to be led by United Nations. All right, United Nations, you know, is the umbrella body of all governments. All right, so who are the countries who have been invited? USA, obviously, because they are the ones who have initiated it. Russia, China, Pakistan, India and Iran. All right, this is who are involved. Now, the purpose or the mandate. All right, what is this for? This is for US withdrawal, because US now wants to withdraw its forces in Afghanistan. Secondly, their proposal, US claim this is for inclusive government. What does inclusive government mean here? That one, there will be the government of Taliban and the government, democratic government of Afghanistan. They should come together and rule. All right. And third thing is permanent and comprehensive ceasefire. That now the risk is, the main concern of US is twofold. One, they are leaving. All right. Once they leave, there will be no other body to support them. Why is this? To support the Afghanistan government. Why is this problematic? Half of the territory of Afghanistan is already under Taliban control. If the military of Afghanistan was strong, they would not have let Taliban rise in the first place. However, that has not taken place, right? So that is one security concern. The second is, once they leave, there is no guarantee as of right now that Taliban will not take over the democratically elected government. So you need two assurances now. First, that once US leaves, there will be no military action, that peace should be there. There should be no continuous war by Taliban on the democratic government. And secondly, that if an agreement is reached for inclusive government, that is half led by Taliban, half by the government there, that this will stay, all right? This will endure. Therefore, other countries have been invited to be part of it, all right? So the main concern is that once US leaves, Taliban will not take over Afghanistan and peace will endure in Taliban. Afghanistan by Taliban, that it will uphold the overall security situation. So this is what the situation in Afghanistan and the proposal of United States is, all right? The government of Afghanistan, that is the democratic one, they do not support it. They believe that this will take place. Once US forces leave, Taliban will start attacking it, and in most likelihood, they will take over the entire country. All right. Why are these countries being invited? Because they are the ones who are in support of either of these parties. Who are these two parties? Taliban and the democratic government. China and Pakistan. Pakistan's role in overall supporting Taliban is considered to be the most prominent one. All right. And these are other regional powers who surround Afghanistan. So they are being invited so that it can be confirmed there are multiple parties to pressurize that status quo, whatever is agreed will be maintained. All right. So May 1 is the deadline, and this is now heating up about what is happening in Afghanistan. All right. If you have any doubts about this, make sure you put it in the comment section. Make sure, one clarification, this is US led. The news of Trioikia is Russia led. All right. Two separate things are happening, all about the same thing. The US one is far more complex. It includes far many parties and is the one which is happening on ground, because US and Taliban are at war in Afghanistan. All right. So the parties, their purpose becomes important for you all to understand the overall situation. All right. On that note, I will conclude for the day. In today's newspaper, update from Uttarakhand about new chief minister, and on the editorial pages, it is about understanding Nepal's overall political situation. No real updates there. All right. Nothing new has happened. So no thing to note down. Just understand what is happening, because when confirmation comes, you are not bewildered. All right. Gestational Diabetes Day on March 10. And moving on national and international news, it is about Afghanistan's proposals. All right. So those things become important from today's newspaper. On that note, thank you so much. Once again, a reminder for all of you, subscribe to our Telegram channel for the daily quiz and the word of the day. On that note, thank you so much. Any doubts, put it in the comment section, and we'll see you tomorrow. Thank you.